morning. I wanted to invite Speaker Gillum and President Dismang to join me if they're in the audience there. I appreciate our legislative leaders and how they conducted themselves throughout the session, and including this process. As everyone knows, House Bill 1228 is now on my desk, and it's time for me to take a look at it and make some comments in reference to it. This is a bill that in ordinary times would not be controversial. But these are not ordinary times. This bill is not really complicated. The bill itself restates the standard of review for the courts to consider in determining First Amendment privileges as weighed against the compelling interest of the state. That's simply stated as a summary as to what this legislation does. It's a balancing test. The bill itself does not pick winners and losers. It balances two competing constitutional obligations that our founding fathers gave to us. But the issue has become divisive because our nation remains split on how to balance the diversity of our culture with the traditions and firmly held religious convictions. It has divided families, and there is clearly a generational gap on this issue. My son, Seth, signed the petition asking me, Dad, the governor, to veto this bill. And he gave me permission to make that reference. And it shows that families, and there's a generational difference of opinion on these issues. So where are we now in reference to this legislation? I have asked through this process of our legislative leaders and members that certain changes be made. In some instances, they were accommodated and changed. In other instances, they said no. And that's the balance between the executive and the legislative branch. I certainly respect those bodies. It's been my intention all along that House Bill 1228, the Religious Freedom Restoration Act, be crafted in a way that mirrors the Federal Religious Freedom and Restoration Act that was passed in 1993 and was signed by President Clinton. I came to Congress after that, but I sat on the Judiciary Committee in the House of Representatives that considered these amendments, had hearings on this Federal Religious Freedom and Restoration Act. And so I'm somewhat familiar with it and how it's played out across the country. And it was my intention, because the federal law does not cover state causes of action, that we have a similar law in Arkansas. And but we wanted to have it crafted similar to what is at the federal level. And to do that, though, changes needed to be made. The bill that is on my desk at the present time does not precisely mirror the federal law. It doesn't mirror it in a couple of ways, particularly allowing the First Amendment to be asserted in the private litigation between parties or the reliance upon the state law and those claims. Therefore, I ask that changes be made in the legislation. And I've asked that the leaders of the General Assembly to recall the bill so that it can be amended to reflect the terms of the Federal Religious Freedom and Restoration Act. In the alternative, it can be simply have some language changes so that those accommodations and changes can be made. So it can either be done by recalling the legislation or having additional legislation that would accomplish those changes. Again, this is difference between the executive branch, the legislative branch. We all have our responsibilities. We all have our different viewpoints. My responsibility is to speak out on my own convictions and to do what I can as governor to make sure this bill reflects the values of the people of Arkansas, protects those of religious conscience, but also minimizes the chance of discrimination in the workplace and in the public environment. It is important to recognize that the bill, even as currently drafted, does not change who we are. And it does not change the current protections against discrimination. This bill simply defines the standard to determine the right balance. But how do we as a state communicate to the world that we are respectful of a diverse workplace and we want to be known as a state that does not discriminate but understands tolerance? That is the challenge that we face. Making this law like the federal law will aid us in that effort in communication, but also it was my original objective from the beginning. Another option is that we're looking at is to utilize an executive order, which interestingly has not been utilized for my research from the executive branch and state government in terms of protecting against discrimination in the workplace for state government. But we're looking at an executive order to aid in that communication and to make it clear that Arkansas wants to be a place of tolerance. We want to be a place that has the right balance between religious protections and religious freedom and non-discrimination. Also, I think we can be assured that this will continue to be a robust debate in the future. I understand that a ballot title has been approved by the Attorney General that may put on the ballot an extension of the civil rights protection to additional classes of citizens of Arkansas. That debate will continue and ultimately be determined by the people of this state, either through their legislative body or through a vote of the people. And so this conversation does not end. I've expressed my view to the legislature. It is up to them to respond to the request of the governor that changes be made in the current bill to make it reflect the federal law that I think sets the right tone for Arkansas in its future. We'll look at additional action down the road as needed, partly depending upon the action that the legislature might take. With that, I'll see if the president has any comments.
Thank you, Governor. First, let me say that I support a RFRA in this session. I think that the majority of both chambers support a RFRA being passed this session. I think there are some complications, and if I'm just being blatantly honest, I've been in the middle of the budget debate probably as much as anything else the last few days. I'd asked some brief questions about the language that we were passing, and actually felt like we were mirroring and actually given some assurances that we were mirroring that federal legislation. And it's my understanding through the business community, other folks in the state of Arkansas, that that was not the case, that this is not does not mirror the federal RFRA language and will actually open the door to some probabilities or uncertainties. I think what we should pass should be something that's predictable. The federal RFRA has been debated, it's been through courts, and there are standards in place and an understanding of what the result of that passage would be here in the state. With the legislation that we have before us, that certainty is not there. And so again, I support us moving forward. I support, and right now, just to be candid, we are having those discussions in the Senate about making those alterations. There's not a conclusion to that discussion, but we want to be sure that our membership has all the information they can in front of them and they can make a decision if this is like a change in the course that they'd like to take. Thank you, Governor.
Questions? Roby? I do not. I've communicated to them my desire. I've made the request of them. I've spoken to the House caucus. I've spoken to the leadership, but I do not have a commitment as to what action they will take.
If this were not fixed, for a better word, you're addressing. It separates it from federal government.
You mean if it's not fixed?
If it goes forward as what is under DAS.
Right.
And you issue an executive action, presumably that would only apply as state agencies, and therefore the issue of private lawsuits would also be.
Yes. Yeah, correct. My executive order will not be the same as a legislative fix. I think the executive order that I'm working on will help in terms of setting the right example of tolerance in this state, will help frame the debate, will help lead our state in terms of expectations of state action, but it will not, but the governing law will be the bill that is ultimately signed into law, the State Legislative Freedom of Protection Act.
Governor, just to be clear, if you don't get the legislative remedy that you are seeking, are you still resolved to sign it?
I am, my position is clear. I've asked them to remedy it. I've asked them to change the current law, and I've asked them to recall it and change the language on it. That's my request today.
Are you leaving your options open?
I will just say I've asked the legislature to do that, and I will make further comments after we determine what action they will take. Yes. Well, one, we have made requests for changes, but, you know, the legislative process is not perfect. You learn as you go on. Many in the community engage in this very late. Obviously, we've been enacting a lot of different legislation, so part of the, you know, there's been insufficient attention to some of the details, perhaps, as it's gone through the legislative process, but it comes to a focal point. But some of the changes I've asked has been communicated previously. So, and I've said it very clear publicly that I think the language I've used is I would support a RFRA that mirrors federal law and is similar to what's been passed in 20-some other states. Now, obviously, there's some variations there, but that's what I've asked for. That has been my position, and we just didn't quite get it perfect through that legislative process. Now, it might be perfect from some people's viewpoint. They've obviously could be very happy with the additional language that is in the Arkansas RFRA, but I have preferred the federal standard on that, and that's what I've asked them to do. I want what is reflected in the federal RFRA law because, as the president said, this has got court cases. You've got a body of law that has interpreted that's very helpful and good guidance. So that's what I think is the right solution there. Again, this legislation is not about picking winners and losers. This legislation is about the right standard and the right balance that courts can interpret this. And so that ultimately, that sense of fairness will be determined by the courts. What is important from an Arkansas standpoint is that, one, we get the right balance, and secondly, we make sure that we communicate that we are not going to be a state that fails to recognize the diversity of our workplace, our economy, and our future. Janelle. Well, as I've said, there's been a learning process through all of this. We've heard from constituents all across Arkansas, business leaders, and so I have said that I would sign a law that is similar in fashion to the federal law or what's been in 20 other states. Whenever you look at what is on my desk, it does not mirror the federal RFRA law, and that's what I prefer, and that's what I would ask them to do. Let me make it clear that this law that is under consideration does not extend discrimination, and that's important. Now, as to whether our civil rights law in Arkansas needs to be changed, that is a debate that's going to happen. I want to focus on what is needed right now. I do think that this bill that would be modeled after the federal law would help achieve that right balance and guidance for the courts and the right standard. Well, the issue on the table is the Freedom Restoration Act, which I want to see enacted in Arkansas in the right form, in terms of where we go in society. I don't believe in a workplace that discriminates. I just, whether it's Tyson's or whether it's Walmart or whether it's Dillard's or whether it's state government, and I will express that view in an executive order when that's prepared. I have had some communication personally with some of the business leaders across the state. Others have communicated in different fashions. And they raise an important issue. And I don't think it's necessarily based upon what's in this law as much as how it's being construed nationally. And so it is a concern. And that's why we have to, as a state, look for means to communicate that we recognize the diversity of our workforce. We are an international community in terms of housing the headquarters of international businesses here in this state, and we want to be able to compete in that market. So this is both about substance, which is getting this legislation right, and it's also about communicating to the world and to our neighboring states that we're a state that recognizes the diversity of the workforce, the need for non-discrimination, and that we want to accomplish that. And so we have to look for ways to communicate that effectively. That's what we're doing right now. And the businesses are doing that right now, and they've really been good partners to communicate that very effectively.
Let me say first and foremost that the House of Representatives, as we have all session long, is committed to working with the Senate and the Governor for solutions on this issue, as we have with a host of many others. We're working through the process now. We're seeing what the dynamics are going to be and what the logistics, and we're going to take them as we go.
I mean, the one thing that we want to make sure is that each member has a chance to take a look at the language that we're discussing. And I think before that, it's probably premature to say that, you know, that there's going to be an agreement. I would hope that there is one, again, really from my perspective, because of the uncertainty that the language has in place if it were to become law. And one thing I do want to say on, and I think I won't speak for each member, but I will say I've not spoken to a member that wants RFRA, this, even the state version, to be something that allows for discrimination. I think I would challenge anyone to find a member that would say that they're wanting to utilize this RFRA law to allow for further discrimination. And I think that's important in the context of what we're talking about doing, or what we're talking about doing, because if we do utilize the federal RFRA and its language, which is proven, which has been through the court process, I think we have the same result as even we had if we were to pass and continue on with the state language, with the exception, we have certainty, which again, I think is important. So thank you.
Listen, this conversation will continue. I thank you for your attention today. Obviously, there's more work to be done, but I wanted to give you an update with this. One final question. Well, every member would have to speak for themselves. In terms of my view on it, I have asked for changes through the process. Some have been accommodated and some have not been accommodated. That's the legislative process. I'm asking the legislature to take a look at this bill, to recall it, or to provide me a changed bill that will make Arkansas RFRA law mirror the federal law. I think that's our objective from the beginning, with variations depending upon the members, but that's what I'm asking them to do. Thank you all very much.